Hello and welcome back. Today we'll talk about the financial effect of penalty of the first major penalty, that is reduction in pay by more than one stage. In the previous two lecture series, we had talked about the minor penalty and its financial effect. I would request all the viewers to, if possible, watch the lecture number 10 or the lecture number 10A to get a very quick idea as to how did we calculate the pay from time to time. It will also save a lot of time in understanding this video. So if you possible, please watch the lecture number 10 or the lecture number 10A. In today's video, we will talk about the financial effect of the penalty number 5, which is the first major penalty. There are five major penalties, out of which this is the first major penalty, which talks about reduction to a lower stage in the time scale of pay for a specified period, with further direction as to whether or not the government servant will earn increments. So during the period of penalty, whether he will earn increment or he will not earn increment, that will have to be stipulated by the discipline authority in the penalty order. Further, it goes on to say that during such period and whether on the expiry of such period, that means the period of penalty is over, whether on expiry of such period, the reduction will or will not have the effect of postponing the future increments of his pay. In other words, this penalty can take four different variations, and those variations can be pictorially shown like this, that reduction to a lower stage for a period of, let us say, 2 years. So reduction by one stage for a period of, let us say, 2 years. The discipline authority can further will have to say in the penalty order that during this period of 2 years, the government servant will earn increment or will not earn increment. Further, if he says he will earn increment, then the discipline authority has another two choices. He can say it will postpone future increments of pay. He can also say it will not postpone future increments of pay. Similarly, if the discipline authority says he will not earn increment, he can say it will postpone future increments of pay. He can also say it will not postpone future increments of pay. So in other words, the penalty can take four different variations. The variation number one could be reduction to by one stage for a period of 2 years, during which he will earn increment, but it will not postpone future increments of pay. Another variation could be that he will earn increments during these 2 years, but it will postpone future increments of pay. The third variation is reduction by two stages or one stage for a period of 2 years, during which he will not earn increment, but it will postpone future increments of pay. And the fourth variation could be that during this 2 year period, he will not earn increment, but it will postpone future increments of pay. These are the four variations. Now, out of these four variations, which appear all possible, but actually this penalty of one of the variation is not practicable, it is not theoretically also possible to be imposed, is when the discipline authority says he will earn increment, then it will not be correct to say it will postpone future increments of pay. So this variation on the extreme left, that is he will earn increment but it will postpone future increments of pay, that is not implementable. We will see why as we go along. So while working out the pay from time to time, we will use the same methodology which we had adopted in the previous lectures. That is, we will write a table in which the first column will be dates. Against each date, we will write the pay during penalty. That is the second column. And in the third column, we will write the pay if there is no penalty on the garment servant. Now, let us take an example. Let us take that reduction is by two stages for a period of 1 year, and the garment servant is drawing in the level 9 a salary of 61,500 in the cell 6. Let us say the penalty is the discipline authority orders that he will earn increment. Will earn, and the discipline authority also says will not postpone future increments. Will not postpone future increments. will earn increment during the period of 1 year, but it will not postpone future increments of pay. Now let us write the salary from time to time, but before that we will have to write the, if you remember, the relevant dates. Now the relevant date, let us again assume that the penalty has been imposed on 1st April 2021. So if the penalty has been imposed on 1st April 2021 for a period of 1 year, obviously the penalty will end on 31st March 2022. So the period of 1 year could be shown by this red box that you see on the screen. You must be wondering why I've kept a gap there between 1st April and 31st March. You guessed it right. That is the date of his increment. So in the column 1, we will have to also write the date of the annual increment. So this will be 1st January 2022. Now, as you can see, the penalty order has been issued on 1st April. For a period of 1 year, reduction by 2 stages, he will earn increment during the period of penalty, but it will not postpone future increments of pay. So let us write the date salary in the column 2 first. First of all, you can see from 1st April, when the on 1st January 2021, there is no penalty on him, so he will draw 61500. So we are now writing the salary on 1st April, 1st January, 31st March. This is the period of his penalty. So let us use a red ink. So on 1st April, his salary will get reduced from 6150 by 2 stages. And you can see on the table on the right that he will come to cell number 4, that is 58,000. So it will become 58,000. If there is no penalty on him, he will continue to get 61500. Now the next important date, that is on 1st January 2022, what salary he will get in this column, that is when the penalty is going on, and what salary he will get if there is no penalty. Let us finish if there is no penalty first. Obviously on 1st January 2022, if there is no penalty on him, he will get his annual increment and it will take him to 63,300. But coming to the salary during penalty, on 1st January is the date of increment. The discipline authority kindly see has ordered that he will earn increment during the period of penalty. So he will earn his increment on 58,000, and therefore it will become 597,000, that is the cell number 5. This he will continue to draw up to 31st March. So we will write 597,000, and if there is no penalty on him, this will be 63,300. Now comes the next date, 1st April 2022. When he is a free man, he is out of the jail. So he is a free man now, what salary he will draw? Kindly see the discipline authority wrote or ordered that it will not postpone future increments of pay. Whenever the word is not postpone future increments of pay, remember, as we discussed in the last previous video, if it is not postpone future increments of pay, which is nothing but non-cumulative, he will get the salary that he would have got had there been no penalty. So, jab bhi non-postponement hai ya non-cumulative hai, to penalty khatam hone ke baad hum usko wo salary denge jo wo leta agar uspe koi penalty nahi lagti. To koi penalty agar uspe nahi hoti, to wo 63,300 leta. To 63,300 leta. So since the penalty is without postponement of future increments, he will get 63,300. And again, on 1st January 2023, his annual increment would arise and he would get 65,200. That is the annual increment which is due to him. Now, if the disciplinary authority orders that he will not earn increments, he will not earn increment. अगर डिसिप्लिन अथॉरिटी ये ऑर्डर करते हैं कि पेनल्टी के दौरान वो इंक्रीमेंट ऑन नहीं करेगा, इन दैट केस थ्रू आउट द पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर ही वुड गेट 58,000 ओनली, नो जंप 58,000. So from 1st April, that is the date of the imposition of the penalty, till the penalty period is over, that is 31st March 2022, he will get 58,000. If it is, he will not earn increment. But in this case, kindly see, we have written it will not postpone future increments of pay. So on the date of 1st April 2022, when he is a free man, since it has been stipulated, it will not postpone future increments of pay, he will get the salary that he would have drawn had there been no penalty, that is 63,300. And again on the date of increment, 1st January 2023, 65,200. So please remember, whenever the discipline authorities order that it will not postpone future increments of pay, the government servant will get the salary that he would have drawn had there been no penalty. But when the discipline authority orders that it will postpone future increments of pay, so if the discipline authority orders that it will postpone future increments of pay, in that case he will get the salary that he was getting prior to the date of imposition of the penalty. So let us say in this case that the discipline authority says it will postpone. So let us remove the word not. It will postpone. So the discipline authority says it will postpone future increments of pay. Then when the penalty is over, that is on 1st April 2022, the government servant will not get 63,300. He will get the salary that he was getting prior to the imposition of penalty, that is 61,500. That is 61,500. So if it is postponement of future increments of pay, in that case, after the penalty is over, the government servant would get the salary that he was getting prior to the penalty, that is in this case 61,500. Now I would also like to apprise all the viewers that the government of India, DOPT, had issued two orders on financial effects of penalty. The second order was issued on 18th June 2019, and one order was issued 5 years before that in 2014 on 6th February 2014. Both these orders are available in the DOPT website. However, there appears to be a mistake in the order dated 6th February 2014. In this order dated 6th February 2014, there is an illustration, case number 2A, reduction to a lower stage, in which the illustration is about a government servant whose salary has been reduced by two stages for a period of 1 year, with the stipulation that it will not have the effect of postponing future increments of pay. So it was expected that the illustration would show that after the penalty period is over, the government servant would get the salary that he would have drawn had there been no penalty. However, there appears to be a mistake in my view when it has been stated that after the penalty is over, the government servant has been shown to given the pay that he was drawing prior to the imposition of penalty, which is not correct. So once the penalty order says that non-postponement, it doesn't postpone future increments of pay, you cannot give the government servant a salary after the penalty period is over, the one he was drawing before imposition of the penalty. But in this case, I would request every viewer to read it on his own and take his own call. In this case, the government servant has been given 196,400, which salary he was getting prior to the imposition of penalty. Although the discipline authority has ordered that it will not postpone future increments of his pay, this appears to have been corrected in the subsequent order on 18th June 2019. But I thought I'll inform all my viewers about this contradiction. So before I conclude, I would once again like to show you this four possibilities that reduction to a lower stage for a period of specified years, during which he can earn increment, he may not earn increment. If he earns increment, two possibilities are there. It may postpone future increments of pay, it will not postpone future increments of pay. If he will not earn increment, again two possibilities are there, postpone future increments of pay and will not postpone future increments of pay. As I told you in the beginning, that one of these four possibilities is not practicable. That is, once the discipline authority says he will earn increment, it will not be correct to say it will postpone future increments of pay. I have not answered that question very clearly as to why this fourth is not possible in this diagram, which is the first possibility. Why it is not possible, I have not discussed. I would request all participants to keep on thinking about it and write to me as to why this first option, that is, he will earn increment but it will postpone future increments of pay, is not possible. Thank you very much. Bye bye. See you next time with the next video on financial effects of the next major penalty, which is reduction to a lower post. So if a person is by penalty reduced to a lower post, how his pay will be fixed. Bye bye. See you next time.